is a spy plane!
Gentlemen, this is a photo opportunity. We have been meeting. In fact, all we've been doing for quite some time is meeting. But Ambassador and I have been meeting with regard to his return tomorrow to the negotiating table in Geneva by way of some of our allies in NATO on the intermediate range nuclear weapons. We had a discussion. This being a photo opportunity, we won't take questions, but he will be briefing you this afternoon and meeting with you at a later moment.
Wouldn't you even want to tell us what this Soviet incident is going to do to those arms control talks?
I'm going to take one question because I meant to say this in my opening remarks and didn't. But, and the only thing is, yes, we are still meeting, and tomorrow we'll be meeting with Congressman on that particular problem, that issue. And I don't believe that should reduce the importance of continuing the talks that we hope will lead to a reduction in the number of nuclear weapons in the world. I think peace is that all important, that we shall continue those talks. But that doesn't lessen our feeling, our anger, about that terrible tragedy and the Soviet attitude that they've taken following. But I think we agree. The disarmament talks must be agreed.
Well, Mr. President, if you say they're barbarians, how can we negotiate with them, sir?
President, have you made any decisions on how to retaliate on the plane incident?
We're meeting on all sorts of things of that kind.
Mr. President, did Israel spoil your plans in the Middle East by beginning its redeployment so early?
No, as a matter of fact, Israel, I'm not supposed to be taking questions, you understand, but I can't help say no. Israel had already delayed twice at our request.
Thank you, lights, please. You guys have just got a special
Thank you.